I have helped over 1,400 people leave their 9-to-5 jobs by replacing their income with digital products and services. But to be honest, this business is brutal, and a lot of people quit before they ever see any success. In this video, I will show you the five deadly sins that cause most people to fail that I make sure my students never ever make so that they can go from living paycheck to paycheck to making four and even five figures every single month with digital products. So let's dive in. Have you ever wondered why some people seem to easily build online businesses while others just fall flat on their faces and fail? It's not often about talent or luck, but by avoiding these five deadly sins. Sin number one, underestimating the power of marketing. Many new entrepreneurs make the mistake of thinking that the product will sell itself. Wrong. Even the best product needs effective marketing. If you don't effectively market your products, no matter how good they are, they won't sell. And this can lead to wasted time, effort, and money. Now, for more info on how to market your digital products, I've already created a video about that, and you can watch it popping up on your screen right now. But understand, no matter how good, how perfect, how great your digital product is, it's not gonna sell if you don't have a great marketing strategy behind it. Deadly sin number two, not niching down. I know a lot of people say, be your own niche, don't niche down, be broad. These things could not be farther from the truth and cause so many newbies to fail. A broad niche can dilute your target audience and make it harder for you to stand out. This can result in lower sales, no sales at all, and a less engaged audience. But I got you. Here's a simple yet powerful framework to help you to niche down. First, identify a broad niche. Start with a broad niche, for example, something like digital marketing. Next, you drill down to a specific pain point. What specific problem does your audience face within that niche? For example, it could be struggling to generate leads online. Now, a way to niche down even further is by getting even more specific. For example, helping beginner bloggers attract organic traffic. This is a more targeted approach and will help you identify the people in your niche to where you can reach more people and get more sales and get more engagement in your content. I'm gonna leave another example on how you can niche down popping up on your screen right now. And now let's move on. Deadly sin number three, overcomplicating things. Overthinking and overanalyzing can lead to analysis paralysis. This can prevent you from taking action and launching your digital products. Now, there are a lot of ways that you can prevent yourself from overthinking and overanalyzing, but I'm going to include one simple way based off the subject matter of this video. And since we're talking about digital marketing, I'm going to use the example of just using PLR products. PLR products can greatly simplify the process of creating and launching an online business. And here's why. Because PLR products are pre-built or pre-made digital products. And because they're already pre-built, they're going to save you time, which means you don't need to start from scratch. PLR products are already proven to be successful. And you can also use templates that have already generated sales, which means you won't have to figure out how to format your digital products to make sure that they solve the problems of your potential customers and they're gonna generate sales in your business. On top of that, PLR products will reduce a great amount of stress. This is gonna lessen the pressure of creating original content from scratch. Removing the stress factor from this whole process is gonna enable you to not overcomplicate things and start overthinking. Now, if you're into digital marketing and you wanna learn more about PLR digital products, I actually have a digital income starter kit, which will give you all of my best-selling and proven ready-made and pre-built PLR digital products that you can resell and brand as your own and keep 100% of the profits. To learn more about that, you'll see the link down below this video. Deadly sin number four, ignoring customer feedback. Not listening to your customers can lead to products that don't meet their needs. This can result in negative reviews, low sales, and a damaged reputation. But how do you get customer feedback? Well, there are two ways I use to get customer feedback in my business that I also teach my students. One is through email. As you grow your digital marketing business, you should be collecting emails in exchange for a freebie or a low-ticket digital product. If you don't have have an email autoresponder, I'm going to link my favorite down below in the YouTube description. But with an email list, you can send out personalized emails asking your subscribers to answer a quick survey and/or give you a review of your products. Second, you can get customer feedback just by simply asking them on social media. Just like this. Tell me what's your biggest struggle with selling digital products? Is it getting started or getting sales? Comment getting started with digital products or getting sales with digital products down in the comments below. It'll help me know what I should be working on to help you guys with the most. See how easy that was? In your content, give a clear call to action to motivate your audience to tell you what's the biggest problem they're having in their business. And I promise you, the data you're going to get back is priceless. And now the final deadly sin, giving up too soon. Success in an online business often requires patience and persistence. Giving up too early can prevent you from achieving your goals. But here's what you can do. Set realistic expectations. Break down large goals into smaller, achievable steps. And also celebrate your small wins to maintain your motivation. A second tip is just learning from your failure. Analyze your mistakes and learn from them. Also, use setbacks as opportunities to grow. And finally, and I stress this the most, don't compare yourself to others. Try not to focus on what others are achieving, but instead only focus on your own progress. Your time is your time. We all have different lives and responsibilities. Don't trick yourself into thinking that just because somebody achieved a level of success in some crazy amount of time, that you're also going to get the same results in the same time frame. We don't know the backstory of how those other people are winning right now in your niche or in that business. No matter what it is, it's only motivation and inspiration that it is possible, but don't compare yourself thinking that they did it in that time. I should be able to do it too in a lesser time. This is crazy thinking and it causes so many people to quit and fail. Now, as promised, I told you if you stick around to the end of this video, I will show you how to create and sell your first digital product in 7 days. In order to learn how to do that, you want to watch this video popping up on your screen right now, because when you pair the information that you learn in this video with the information you're going to learn in the next video, it's going to make you way more powerful. Till then, stay blessed, and I'll see you on the other side of success or the next video, whatever comes first. I'm out.